Pagdating araw po, ako po inyong teacher, si Teacher Nercy. Sa video ito, i-discuss po natin ang pag-compute ng mean from grouped data. May tatlong paraan para po ma-compute ang mean. Una, yung direct method or long method. Pangalawa, yung deviation method. Pangatlo, yung coding method. Sa direct method or long method, ginagamit po ito kapag ang class interval ay hindi pare-parehas. So, ang formula po nito ay x bar is equal to summation of fx times divided by summation of f. Okay? So, halimbawa, use the frequency distribution of heights to find the mean height of 100 male students in XYZ university. Use direct method. So, the first step is get a class mark of each class. Put it in another column with a label x. Yan. Gawa tayo ng bagong column, lagyan natin ng label na x. Ito yung class mark or class midpoint. So, para ma-compute po yung class mark or class midpoint, i-plus lang po natin yung lower class limit at saka upper class limit and i-divide it by 2, which is 61. So, 63 plus 65 divided by 2, 64. Gawin mo yan sa bawat class. Yung second step natin ay i-multiply natin yung column f sa column x. 5 times 61. And record it in another column labeled fx or f times x. So, 5 times 61 is 305 and so on. Then, after that, add all these numbers. Then, find the summation of fx which is equal to 6,745. So, alam na natin yung value na n or summation of f. Alam na rin natin yung value na summation of fx. So, makukompute na natin yung mean. So, substitute lang natin yung formula, yung value. Okay? Sa mean. So, mean is equal to 67.45 inches. Sa second method or the deviation method, ito po yung formula. So, x bar or mean is equal to a or the class midpoint dash yung mean. Then, summation of fd over n. So, gamitin ulit natin yung example natin, yung frequency table na ginamit natin sa long method. So, yung first step natin is identify the assumed mean by dividing the total frequency by 2. Compare it with the cumulative frequency until you reach 50 or more. So, dinivide natin yung 100 divided by 2, which is 50. Ano yung 100? That is the total frequency. So, i-compare natin yung value na 50 sa cumulative frequency from the lowest class hanggang sa makuha natin yung 50 or more value. So, 5 is less than 50. So, wala dito yung A, the first class. What about sa second class? So, 5 plus 18, 23 is less than 50. So, wala pa rin dito sa second class yung A. Nasaan yung A? So, let's proceed to the third class. So, 65 is more than 50. So, therefore, our A here is on the third class. Okay? Nandito. So, the next step is get the class mark. Okay? Alam na natin pag-compute ng class mark. So, our A is 67. This is the class mark or class midpoint of the third class. Okay? 67. Then, the next step is subtract the class mark of the assumed mean to the class mark of each class. Record it in another column with a label D is equal to X minus A. Or simply, lagyan mo lang dito ng D. So, to compute the D, so subtract natin yung X class mark sa A. So, 61 minus 67, negative 6. 64 minus 67 is negative 3, and so on. Ito na yun. Okay? Then, next step is we have to write another column. We have to insert another column in our frequency table. Kasi imumultiply natin yung frequency, yung f, times d. Okay? So, 5 times negative 6 equals negative 30. Ilagay natin yung answer in another column. So, lagyan natin ng label na f. So, multiply it. 18 times negative 3 is negative 54. 2 times 0 is 0, and so on. So, kapag nagawa mo na lahat, itotal mo yung values under FD. So, summation of FD is equal to 4 to 5. So, mayroon na tayong values summation of F, mayroon na tayong values summation of FD, at alam na rin natin yung value na A. So, isosubstitute na natin yung mga values sa ating formula. So, our mean is 67.45 inches. So, pares pa rin sa long method. Yung last method is coding method or short method. Ang formula po dito ay X bar is equal to A plus summation of FU over N times C. So, mayroon tayong C na ginamit dito. This is the class size. Bakit may C dyan? Kasi po, itong method na ito ay ginagamit lamang kapag ang class sizes o class interval ay pare-parehas. Okay? So, gamitin natin yung frequency table na ginamit natin sa dalawang methods. So, yung first step natin, i-analyze po natin kung yung class interval ba dito o class sizes ay pare-parehas. So, kung susuriin natin, pare-parehas yung class interval dyan. Ang class interval dyan ay 3. Okay? 3 ang class interval. Second step is identify the position of your A or the assumed mean. So, parehas din ng deviation method. Okay? So, i-divide natin yung total frequency by 2, which is 50, then compare the 50 to the cumulative frequency of each class, beginning with the lower class. So, 50 compared to 5, so 5 is less than 50, so wala dyan yung A. Proceed to the second class, 18 plus 5 is 23, which is less than 50, wala dito yung A. Proceed to the third class. So, the cumulative frequency of the third class is 65, which is more than 50. So, therefore, our A is on the third class. Okay? Then, kunin ulit natin ang class mark ng bawat class. Okay? So, yan. Then, after that, yung next step natin is add another column and label it U. Under this column, write 0 in the assuming class. So, ang ating assuming class ay third class. So, ilalagay down natin dito ng 0. Okay? Negative 1 to the class below it and so on. So, negative 1 to the class below the median, the assuming class. So, negative 1. Of course, ang susunod dyan, negative 2. Kung mayroon pa, negative 3, negative 4, and so on. Write 1 to the next higher class, the assuming class, and so on. So, the next higher class of the third class is, of course, the fourth class. So, maglalagay tayo dito ng 1. So, next higher class is the fifth class. Lalagay natin dito ay 2. Kung mayroon pa, susunod 3, 4, 5, and so on. The next step is we multiply column F with column U. So, record it in another column, FU or F times U. So, 5 times negative 2 is negative 10. 18 times negative 1 is negative 18, and so on. Then, get the sum of this column. Summation of FU is equal to 15. Then, we know the values of N and summation of FU, and we know already the values for A and C. So, substitute these values to the formula. Then, our mean is 67.45 inches. Okay, another example. The frequency table shows the monthly load expenses of 75 students. Okay, another example. The frequency table shows the monthly load expenses of 75 students. Compute the mean. So, use any method. So, kung susuriin natin yung ating frequency table here, pare-pares yung ating class interval. So, gamitin ko dito ay ang short method or coding method. So, the table has a class size or class interval of 50. Okay? So, then, let's compute A by getting the 50% of the total frequency or 75 divided by 2, so 37.5. So, kunin natin yung cumulative frequency. So, 7 plus 11, 18 plus 17 plus 20, so 55. So, nandito, 37.5. So, ibig sabihin nasa 4th class yung A natin. Okay? The fourth class will be our assumed mean. So, it has a plus mark of 199 plus 150 divided by 2. So, 174.5 yung value ni A. So, ang ating assumed mean class ay fourth class. So, ilalagay natin dito sa fourth class ay 0 under column U. Then, negative 1 below, doon sa class below the assumed mean class. Negative 1, negative 2, and negative 3. Then, sa next higher class of the assumed mean class, lalagay natin ay positive 1. Then, positive 2. So, that is the value of column U. Ang susunod na gagawin natin, imumultiply natin yung column F or yung frequency times U. So, 7 times negative 3 is negative 21. 11 times negative 2 is negative 22. 17 times negative 1 is negative 17. 20 times 0 is 0. 15 times 1 is 15. 5 times 2 is 10. Then after that, i-plus mo yan lahat. Okay? So negative 21 plus negative 22 plus negative 17 plus positive 15 plus positive 20 is what? Negative 30. Then, we can now compute the mean. So, A, alam natin ang A is 174.5 times summation of FU, which is negative 35, divided by N, or total frequency, which is 75, and C is 50, which is equal to 151.17 pesos. Yun na po. Yan. So, I hope na mayroon kayong natutunan dito sa video ito. Maraming salamat po. Hanggang sa muli.